Hey, what's up guys, this is Spanky. You probably just watched me do a review of this figure, and the hip joint is really, really, really loose. It's got some other loose joints there, but I've watched a few videos online about how to fix these. People have used nail polish and other lots of other sorts of things, but what I'm going to use actually is glue, and that scares a lot of people, but I've done it before and it's worked before, so hopefully it works again. Let's hopefully I don't break this figure, but if I do break the figure, I'm going to post it anyway so you guys know not to do it. If that makes sense. So this is a bit of experiment. I have done it before, like I said, but not with this kind of joint. I did it before with a ball joint, and these RevoTech joints are a little bit different. First, I just want to identify which joint is actually really loose. It's not the upper one as much as it is the bottom one. And I'm going to get these just to help pull this out. Alright, so we got this little joint here that's loose. Pain in the ass. It's annoying. Let's try to fix it. So here's the kind of glue that I use. Loctate Super Glue Gel Control. Generally, I would like to use the glue that says it dries up in 10 seconds or less. The one that dries up really quick, because what I'm about to show you, you don't want to sit there and do it for a long time. You don't want it to dry up afterwards. So yeah, you want the glue that's going to dry up as fast as possible for this method of joint fixing. So what I'm going to do here is make sure there's a little crack in there for that gel to get in there and just add a drop. I don't need much glue at all. Get the other side. Okay. Now the trick is not letting it dry and stick together. And the good thing about this glue is that it's not a really strong glue, so I think even if this did end up sticking together, it's not going to break it. It's just strong enough to keep them together or film, make a small layer, but not strong enough to make it stick, if that makes any sense. And this is just helping it not stick. It's just getting in all the grooves, make sure it doesn't glue into place. So that's why I'm moving it over. Kind of just scraped it off the edges. Hopefully it got actually inside the joint a little bit more. I can actually feel it. It's a little bit rougher now to move up and down. My finger itches. Take a close look at it. I think for the most part it is dry. So I did that. I didn't do it for very long. It was about a minute of moving it back and forth so that it doesn't lock in place. And you can already see that it's changed a little bit. That came out really easily, unfortunately. I mean, this thing's got a whole bunch of joint problems, but that was the major one I wanted to fix. Bam. Alright. So there you go. Still a little bit. Let's see if I can get them to like, let's see. That's a lot better. I would not do that before. So there you go. There's my method for fixing broke joints. You may have to reapply every once in a while, but as you can see, this does do the job. Just make sure you keep moving it so that the glue just doesn't rest in there and just glue it together. You've got to keep moving it, and eventually the glue will dry, but it will dry as a film and a spacer to add some friction for this joint here, and that's the key. If you watched my video of this review of this figure, then you know I was not able to pull off the stance, and all I did was poke it in a little peg hole there in the bottom of his foot and sand him straight up. And if you've seen the video, this was not possible, so this is a little bit of proof that it did work. Like I said, there's a bunch of other ways to fix joints, but this is the way I do it. It's pretty cheap. It's been pretty effective. You just got to get some of this Loctite super glue. Like again, make sure you get the glue that dries quickly. You don't want to sit there and do that forever, because there are different types of this glue. One that'll dry slowly and one that'll dry quickly. So there are different two types. Gel control is just referring to the fact that this little spout here, it's easy to control the gel and make a straight line. That's all that's about. And you don't need a lot of glue. I just use small drops. I'm not sure how long it'll hold. I haven't time tested it or anything. The other figure I used it on, it did get a little bit loose again, but it's really not that hard to reapply. And also, the main thing is that it dries clear. You're not going to see it there on the joint at all. It's not going to show up. It's a little bit shiny, but from where I'm at, my perspective, I can't see it at all. So, yeah. Thanks for watching, guys. I do appreciate it. Peace out.